expectation is correlation of quality of vision, lens density, and dysfunctional lens index in presbyopes. The authors have no financial interest in the subject matter of this presentation. As we know that the diagnosis of cataract surgery has evolved over the years from naked eye to torchlight, slit lamp, and now high magnification. Similarly, the tools to diagnose cataract also have evolved from torch to slit lamp. For the longest time, gold standard was the LOX3, and now objectively to the pentacam and the eye trace. We often encounter patients between 40 to 60 years of age in our OPDs who are night drivers who complain of glare, halos, and starbursts. When we examine these patients, mostly both patients' best corrected visual acuity is 6x6. And most of these patients have clear lenses as well. Now, if we go into the review of literature, American Journal of Ophthalmology actually published that vision-specific quality of life research gives traditional approaches to developing rating scales. Also, dysfunctional lens index has already been, dysfunctional lens syndrome has already been given a terminology and coined to describe the natural aging changes in the crystalline lens. And along with that, there is growing acceptability of objectively quantifying how much the cataract has occurred. We have the DLI on the eye trace, wherein we get the internal aberrations and the external aberrations separately, giving the term dysfunctional lens syndrome. The current modalities cannot quantify this dysfunctional lens. So are aberrations enough? Introducing dysfunctional lens index on the eye trace system. This has already been published in the Journal of Cataract and Refractive Surgery, comparing the dysfunctional lens index and the Scheimpflug lens densitometry, along with the objective metrics of quantifying the syndrome with visual acuity and phacodynamics. So that got us to a research question: can we obtain any parameter that can quantify the dysfunctional lens, and can we correlate it with metrics of quality of vision? Aim is to describe the dysfunctional lens index in presbyopes and its correlation with quality of vision and lens density changes based on the LOCS3 and Scheimpflug lens density. Inclusion criteria included patients of age group between 40 to 60 years, clear lens and early lens changes on slit lamp evaluation. Exclusion criteria were presence of corneal opacity, posterior subcapsular cataract, obvious lenticular changes requiring cataract surgery, posterior segment pathologies, or any systemic issues limiting the visual potential. The study was approved by the ethics committee and informed consent was taken from all the patients. The sample size was 158 patients. Materials and methods: it was a prospective observational cross-sectional study. All 158 patients were subjected to visual acuity, which was 6x6. Following this, a slit lamp grading was done on the basis of LOCS3. This was followed by a PNS staging on the pentacam and followed by a DLI, MTF area under the curve, and internal aberrations on the eye trace system. A quality of life questionnaire was also handed out to all these 158 patients. So the PNS staging on the eye trace is displayed as a figure of 0, 1, or 2, and it comes in this manner. And in the eye trace, we get the DLI as a number between 0 and 10, as is mentioned here, in this particular case being 5.78. So the results, the age average was 57.92 years. Total patients, 75 male, 83 females, and the DLI less than 5 was 17 patients, 5 to 7, 45 patients, and more than 7 in 96 patients. So we did a comparison between the slit lamp examination and the PNS grading, and what we found was that out of the 76 cases that we made clear on the slit lamp, the pentacam gave it a grade 1 out of 51 patients. And the 82 patients which were lens changes on the slit lamp, the pentacam gave it as grade 0. Whereas when we did for the eye trace, out of the 76, the eye trace gave DLI between 5 and 7 on 13 cases and maximum in DLI range of more than 7. And out of the 82 patients that were lens changes on slit lamp, 40 cases were given DLI more than 7. This is a pictorial depiction of the same. Also, when we compared the quality of vision, what we got was that the modular transfer function was directly related to DLI. So was the Stirl's ratio, which is contrast sensitivity. And the internal HOA on expected lines was inversely related to DLI. And when we see this, that the grading of the cataract also in DLI less than 5 patients was the maximum given in the eye trace. Now, if we do a correlation between the pentacam, this was an incidental finding, and the pentacam as well as the DLI on the eye trace, what we found was the average density pentacam matched maximum with the eye trace, whereas at the present moment, what we take is a maximum density. So the DLI can be the new gold standard for refractive lens exchange, also because it gives us the objective symptoms that the patient is having. A QLL index out of the 158 that we had given, 14 patients had DLI more than 5, less than 5, and 10 patients out of this underwent cataract surgery. Average 40% increase in QOL was seen in patients 1 month post-op. So what we know as presbyopia is the earliest subtle change in the lens before development of senile cataract. The DLI is an entity where patients experience poor quality of vision in spite of having 6/6 vision. Replacing the natural dysfunctional lens with an artificial IOL corrects the visual symptoms of the patient. Eye-trace is one of the most important tools in decision making in this management, and DLI can be a biomarker for refractive lens exchange. DLI is a reliable quality performance indicator of lens, and it tells us if a lens is looking, lens looks like a cataract and acts like a cataract. Transitional potential, we are currently working on an index linking DLI and phaco settings for objective application, and visual quantification of lens has tremendous potential in patient counseling for cataract surgery. Thank you.
Thank you, Ron. Very good presentation.
Thank you. So are you heading towards PLE for 6/6 visions? Are you heading for RLE for patients with 6/6 vision?
So the thing is,
have you proven that IOL takes care of all those things which you have already, which you told?
No.
All those aberrations and quality of vision. So let's not make very sweeping conclusions.
Yes. So, ma'am, only patients who have frequent change of glasses and are having problems with those frequent change of glasses, those are the patients on which we don't have answers, whether these aberrations are coming from the cornea or are they coming from the lens. Now, with this dysfunction lens index, we can actually see separately whether these aberrations are coming from the cornea or the lens.
Whether they will not come from the other lens is another question.
So, ma'am, we did, as I showed in my last slide, we did the quality of lens, the quality of life index on those patients, and we found that 40% increase in the happiness quotient in the quality of life after this. So, the glares, halos that they were having with the normal crystalline lens actually decreased after we did for these 10 patients.
Okay, already done us.
Yes, ma'am, it was there in my last slide.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a very subjective thing. There are other things like astigmatism and type of lens put, and so cannot be applied in all patients. We have to take utmost caution in this kind of decision.
Ma'am,
this
that's
is a very
what
informed
I said.
And
even patient
decision.
Counseling on this, because we have a very, because there is an indicator that is there. So right now, what we are saying is subjectively, you have this much of cataract. When we can show the patient that this is the number from 0 to 10, it makes a difference.
Yeah, it's not the same. We all know as presbyopes. It's a major, visual handicap in a way.
Okay.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes. Also, sir, that we know that 65% of India is less than 35 right now. So in the next decade, it is extremely important because maximum population will be going into that age group which is there in this. So 65% of India is less than 35 at the moment according to the census. Yes, yes.
It was a good presentation, doctor. Thank you. Anyone who were not there have come back again? So we are ending this session now. Thanks a lot.